what's happening, gamers? Welcome back to Paper Mario Color Splash, and it's time for Circus! So grab your circus peanuts, an elephant, and let's have a great time, the Emerald Circus.
And let's put a tiny cat, or a hat, on our cat, and let her balance on a tightrope.
Unicycle? I don't think her little feet would reach the pedals. Oh, a giant tent in the middle of the forest!
Ooh, this looks fun.
New England Circus. This must be the Emerald Circus, right? In New England!
Yeah.
Or London.
Yeah, London is foggy. Well, I mean, never been there, but I've heard. I'll have to ask Larry.
We did talk to Larry all the time about the fog, and he was like, oh, so if I ever came to visit, it'd be like home. It's like, yes.
Yep. Yeah, Massachusetts is very much like...
Well, near the Cape.
Isn't that... That must be why they call it New England.
I never thought of that.
It's like similar. Well, of course, I mean, the people from there went to Massachusetts. But isn't that interesting that it was like, it's so similar? It's like the whole, like,
can I say something stupid?
Weather. That's weird.
Yeah. When I was little, I thought New England was a state. I didn't know it was a series of states.
No, I mean, New Mexico is a state.
I know.
So, I mean, it doesn't make
I was
any
always
sense.
Looking, whenever we would visit Massachusetts and Connecticut, I was like, where's New England? And they're like, what do you mean? It's like, well, they said we just passed through New England. We were just in, like,
yeah,
Massachusetts
we were just in
or
New York
Connecticut.
Or Maryland or...
No, they don't call New England New York.
Oh.
That's New England.
So that'd be New Hampshire,
New
Delaware,
Hampshire.
Rhode Island.
No.
Yeah. Okay.
There's a limit of 50 tickets for Shy Guys, and they're all sold out. Oh, no. That's kind of sad. What
oh,
about
wait,
this
no,
guy?
Not Delaware.
Not Delaware. I heard the ringleader is prepping special surprise for his performance. I wonder what it is. No, New England, I always thought as Massachusetts, New Hampshire, Connecticut, and
Rhode Island.
And Rhode Island, yeah.
Like those four.
Yeah.
Basically.
Yep.
Yeah, that makes sense.
This is performer's entrance. You a performer? No, didn't think so.
Well, it's interesting that a lot of the people in Massachusetts, especially people who have been there for generations, some of their accents actually sound a little like English, like the way that they say things. Like,
oh my gosh! Thanks a ton for rescuing me, Mario. I went to pet a Yoshi, but suddenly it chewed me up and spit me out. Ouch. That's a captain. I'm the leader of the Red Rescue Squad. You can tell by the white scarf and the all red.
Oh, yeah, he's the
captain.
I
wish you could stay up and chat, but I've got to get to the rendezvous point pronto.
Okay. All right, like the people that I worked with at the insurance agency, they had somewhat of a... Oh, these guys are trained, so we can't put them in the circuit yet. Their tongues are a liability.
Why are their tongues a liability?
Oh my gosh! Is this supposed to be like a... Oh, I don't know. I was thinking Jurassic Park thing, but maybe I'm wrong.
You think it's a Jurassic Park?
Yeah, I don't know. Maybe I'm wrong. No. Like, the way that they... Like, some of the people...
Listen here, dino dragon things. It's not okay to go around eating people whole. It could be the raptor joke. I mean, you don't even know where Mario's been. I'd go brush my teeth if I were you. You tell them, Huey.
Clever girl.
Nah, he's not going to say anything. Say anything different. All right, that's what I get for trying to open the Yoshi cage. My bad.
Yeah, actually, I can't think of the words right now.
Thanks again for saving me, big back there, Mario. Okay, one of our informants told me that there's a big paint star inside the circus tent. No, really? I wouldn't have guessed that. The Red Rescue Squad is gearing up to bust in and seize it, but none of my 49 squad members? Oh, no.
Oh, my gosh. Are you serious?
Oh, no.
We can't rescue 49 people.
If you see any, tell them I'm here. Go to the port.
Please send them my way. Over and out.
Watch, we have to get, like, 16 or 30 of them.
All right, like, some people from that area would speak, like, I can't this, or I, you know, I have to, you know. Not, like, not everybody spoke, like, pack the cat. Like, some people would
pack the cat,
Some people were, like, more, like, it was more, like, really proper. I don't know how to explain it.
Proper
but
way of
some,
speaking?
Yeah, some people almost had an English accent that were around there. It was like between Massachusetts and English, if you can, whatever that is.
I don't know.
Yeah. Okay, it really happened, okay? I'm serious.
I always thought I would get a Bostonian accent for living there, but I think what happened was when I grew up in New York, and then I went to Illinois for like 7 or 8 years, and then I went back to college in New York, then moved to Massachusetts, it kind of like ruined my East Coast accent.
So yeah, it did. Well, I mean, you can go both. Like, when you go towards New York again, you just start to morph into it. You naturally start talking like that again. Like, more. Because I noticed that your voice gets a lot deeper when you get to New York. Like, it just naturally does.
Attention, Red Rescue Toads. Report to your captain in the Emerald Circus on the double. Please tell me there's 49 of you there. Understood. Over now.
Yeah, like your accent gets much more pronounced as we start getting, because you start hearing like what you used to hear when you were younger, mm-hmm. and it's like you just start to naturally speak like you used to.
That's cool.
So, yeah, it is actually pretty cool.
Here's the latest rescue squad info. Okay. Missing one. Oh no. What? But that level's over. Oh no!
What?
Oh no!
Missing one toad?
How do you get back on the Sunset Express?
I don't even know what kind of accent I have because I grew up in, Illinois.
It's very Chicagoan.
Yeah, I mean, I've heard everyone that I'm around says, or that I've heard, like, that people say that I have an. Like, when I came to Pennsylvania, people were like, oh my gosh, are you from Chicago? It's like, I just came from Massachusetts, so. But I guess I speak. Chicago? I don't know. I was actually born, like, right near Chicago. Like
Highland Park.
Like, 15 minutes away. Mm-hmm. Yeah, exactly. So I was basically lived in. And then my brother was actually born in Chicago. So I was actually born. I was actually lived most of my really early life, like, right in Chicago. So mm-hmm. I guess it makes sense that I'd have a Chicago accent.
How in the world do we get to, where's Sunset Express? Do you remember? Well, let's go check here at the circus and see if they... Because remember, maybe that toad that we got, the little magnifying glass guy?
Yeah.
Maybe it's like some type of stand-in. Because remember it said he was an apprentice? Maybe he counts as the 49th toad.
Oh. Oh, look at all these people.
I can't believe I found all these people. I don't even remember doing it.
It's crazy. Oh my gosh.
48. Dang it.
Oh, because he's the 49th, and then there has to be one more. I cannot believe this. I actually always wish I could be cool with like either a New Jersey or New York accent. I would pick one of those.
Jersey?
Yeah, I think New Jersey people sound really cool. What?
What?
I do.
I'm gonna stop now. I'm gonna stop.
But I can't. I think I would sound weird with a New York accent or something. So I'm just gonna stick with what I have.
You'd be cute.
Just sticking with what I have. I don't think I could be intense. Like, but I do miss. I don't think people take me very seriously on the phone. Mm. But they sure do you.
Depends.
It depends who you're. Yeah, it depends where we're calling.
See, look, the train isn't moving. So,
yeah.
Well, at least we can paint this stuff in. I have no idea how we're going to do this. This is my first time ever revisiting this level.
Mm-hmm.
So... Oh, it doesn't seem like there's anything if we keep walking this way. Yeah, whatever.
Yeah, well, that's my dream, K-Wing. Maybe someday if we were... If this channel gets 1 billion subscribers...
Don't need 1 billion.
Then we will move to New York City, and then you can get your New York accent back.
I would never live in New York City, though.
Really? You wouldn't? Uh-uh. You wouldn't want to go, like, to the theater and
No, I'd live...
Out.
I would live, like, I'd probably still live in Pennsylvania, but I would live in, like, one of those mountain cities that's closer to New York City. That way you can either hop on the train... Be like 30 minutes on the train.
Mm-hmm.
And then you don't have all the expenses of New York and you can still go visit it.
That's true. Like, if you're just a little bit away, like.
Right.
Because I used to, like, I was saying, I think I was talking to you before a little bit, saying that I, thinking about how when I used to, had to drive into Boston for school and stuff, I didn't actually park in Boston. Because you can't, it's too expensive. So I just, park near Boston at the train station, take mm-hmm. the train in, go there, come back on the train, then get my car. It's way too expensive to park in the city. It's just ridiculous.
Totally.
I'm sorry, I just called Boston a city. I meant that city. I know what the city is.
The city is always New York City.
That's right. I just wanted to somehow, I wished I could move back to New York to get your accent back. Ah. More how it was, but you still always have it. It's just not...
Pens.
Yeah. We'll just have to... Oh, what? We have to go back?
I don't know what I'm doing. They said that there's a rescue toad, but I don't know where he is.
All right.
Because we got all the toads inside the suitcase, right? Mm-hmm. We got the toad who called everybody a nerd on the train.
Yeah.
We got the toad who was hiding in the coal.
Yep.
We got the toad that was hiding from that spooky thing. That's all the toads on the train.
Mario, we owe you big time!
Even, remember that one toad who said, you know, I'll go when I'm good and ready? He was like, one of the last toads.
So K-Wing, what are you excited about for the Switch coming up? When we finally do coverage of it?
The indie titles, actually.
You're excited about the indie titles?
Mm-hmm. I'm so glad our stupid Sunset Express is back. Yeah, whatever. Get me on your train. I need to look for something.
Yes! The Sunset Express! The Sunset Express is leaving!
What was that?
I don't know. I think that was the train.
Really?
I think it was.
That scared me. Either that or my yawns sound different.
Yeah.
I have like a train yawn.
Yeah, no, that was the train, I think.
Oh, peekaboo shy guy.
I think that somebody next to us has no muffler on their car, though, because it just, I don't know.
Peekaboo. Yeah, totally. There he is!
I'll go in my own time!
You'll go now, mister!
Oh, we didn't hit him off the edge!
Well, I didn't know I was supposed to hit him.
Yeah, he said don't push me.
Oh, I pushed him, all right. Well, let's get some free coins while we're here. And by free coins, I mean coin.
You were just giving him time.
I was giving him a pep talk. I was saying, all right, it's time for you to go now. Bye-bye. Have a nice trip. See you next fall.
Yep.
Now, we actually have a funny story today. We thought that we had... that Nintendo actually sent the Switch anyway. It turns out it was our good friends over at Power who sent us some Switch accessories, which we'll be showing you guys.
Yeah, we were for a second, but I really like the accessories. They're really cool, but...
The train is about to pull in the Starlight Cape.
I was thinking for a minute it was a Switch, but it wasn't. It wasn't.
We should probably check
the mailbox. Little box in the back, just in case. Yeah. Oh my gosh.
Because they did say some more people were going to get it, like, right around release, so...
What?
Then maybe we'll have another system to give away, I don't know.
It's cray-cray.
We'll see. You going to stop anytime soon?
Toad is so cute. Look at his little smut all over his face. Or whatever it is, coal.
What did you call it?
I thought it was like... what was it called?
It's not smut.
What was it called?
Soot!
Soot!
What in the world?
That's what I meant to say! I meant to say soot!
21 plus! Actually, I don't even know if that term is still used these days. I haven't heard that term in a long time.
You know what I just heard when we were at the store today?
No.
There was... can I tell you? Did you hear it?
No.
The lady was talking to the other lady and said, oh my gosh, what are you doing out here? And she said, oh, I'm just lollygagging. And I was like, oh my gosh, somebody else uses that word.
I am truly in the Midwest.
Because I use that word, and so does Mabel.
Yep.
Yeah, that was amazing.
Mario, sir, I'm a huge fan. Thanks for taking the time to talk to a normal toad like me with no unique traits or discernible characteristics.
That's funny. Oh my god.
Rescue, rescue, oh, rescue, beep, beep, rescue, oh, rescue, hey, rescue!
What does this one say?
Toad number 8 of the rescue squad, oh, this line! I'd rather be in the trunk!
That wasn't very uplifting.
No.
Roll call!
Whoa.
Please tell me that's it. Yay!
Yay! I'm so happy!
All that's left is to wait until the show opens.
Let's hope there's not a bull in here that could...
Don't give me scary memories. I was actually more terrified of the clown. I was. I begged my dad to leave the circus. It's not funny. I was traumatized.
It is scary. The clowns are scary.
After experiencing the freedom of flying through the air, I think I'm going to start my own circus.
But I never had a bad experience with clowns. I've only had clowns make me balloon animals, which is very sweet of them. So I just never had any bad experiences.
Maybe the clown was having a bad day, but I'll tell you. Okay. The show will start as soon as the house fills up.
Oh my gosh, I don't know if I can take this.
Oh yeah? That's an audience. It's going to be a full house. Alright, yeah. So there was this one clown.
Thank you for waiting. Take your seats.
It was a mime, though. And he broke character. He was making balloon animals and a kid's...
No way! Yep. He did not break character. Okay, yeah, go
he
ahead.
He was breaking... He broke character. And I was at some kid's birthday party. And the mime was frustrated because he couldn't make, like, a cat or something.
Yeah.
He got really mad at me. He broke character. He talked at me with his clown makeup. And then he popped the balloon in my face.
Oh my gosh!
I was 7! Wow, this circus, it's so lively in here.
No way.
Every seat is full and the audience is giddy with anticipation. Yeah, and then I told my friends that, you know, that mime spoke and they thought
you were crazy.
Yeah, because the mother said that's a mime, you know, don't ruin little Jimmy's party. Oh, I've never actually been to the circus before, I'm super excited.
Why does all this stuff always happen to you?
Because I'm cursed.
Oh my gosh, I've never had a mime speak to me.
That's why I always want to punch mimes.
Wow, that's scary.
Ladies and gentlemen, toads and shy guys, plumbers of all ages.
It's like scary a mime talking to you because it's like having...
Moments away from experiencing the Emerald Circus and all of its glory. I know, right?
It's like having your cat talk to you or something.
Without further ado, allow me to introduce our first act. It's the show everyone's talking about.
It's like mimes are not supposed to talk.
No, they're not.
It's disturbing.
Lemmy's Super Illusion Show. And they're not supposed to pop balloon animals in front of your face.
I actually heard, Well, I'll tell you later.
This is actually probably the first time I've ever heard a clown swear. Thank you. God. It is I, Lemmy, the greatest and most humble illusionist in all the world. The things you're about to see may shock you. They might astound you, but they'll definitely impress you. Oh, that's right. Lemmy's supposed to be crazy. Sorry. I got this. There we go. Spotlight!
Rainbow Dash!
Now the Ringmaster is here just for your average garden variety shy guy. Yes, you! Don't look so surprised!
I'm surprised! Lemmy, you're doing a great job.
Oh my gosh. Now feast your eyes on this magic wand. Sounds like a possessed, like, yogi bear. Phenomenal arcane power in a slim, user-friendly stick.
Now your soul is mine.
Oh, they did a genie joke. Now you see him. Bippity boppity. Boom.
Oh my gosh, you made that guy disappear.
What? Where'd he go? Did I vaporize him?
I hope not.
Toads are like, wait
Did
a second.
Did you just destroy that
meow,
person?
What's going on? Meow, meow. Whoa.
You, sir, have you seen him?
Oh, that guy. Oh, there he is. He's right there.
Wow.
Oh, it's not Toad.
Thank you. You're so easily entertained.
Oh, he should have said you.
And now. The green thing.
I messed that up.
The big paint star.
I should practice before I do this.
That's right. Ah. That's exactly right. It's a shiny green big paint star.
It was supposed to be the shy guy saying it.
Now, watch closely. Yes, it was. That's okay, Amber.
You, sir. Have you seen him?
There you go.
You're fired.
No, sadness.
You're
fired. Sadness!
Give me a cookie. Now, wherever could the big paint star have gone?
I don't know. You stole the Beanstar!
With the ridiculous mustache and rusty can.
Hey!
It's like Bullwinkle. Where do you think that squirrel is? Where's that extra special big paint star ran off to? You didn't need that, did you?
That's funny.
Gee, Rocky!
Nope. Never mind.
Come on, Bullwinkle!
Where did the paint star go? That Lemmy guy made it disappear before he escaped it! Escaped!
Dang it!
Escaped it!
What?!
Lemmy disappeared? That's not in the script!
None of this is in the script!
This is all ad-lib! Oh, geez, oh no! We've got a stall! Get out there and do something!
Oh no!
The lights came on. Intermission, I bet. Hey, folks! How's
Yay,
it going?
He's back.
We're experiencing some technical difficulties. It seems that our main performer has vanished. So please enjoy this unscheduled intermission. Called it! When the lights come on during a show, it's intermission.
Oh, okay.
Mario, that Lemmy guy must be Bowser's underling. I knew it the moment I saw that mug of his.
Bowser, I thought it's his kid.
I can still smell the big paint stars, so
right?
It must be close.
Well, remember that Super Mario Bros. 3 cartoon in the 90s?
Mm-hmm.
They were all related. Let's go find it.
I thought they were all kids.
I guess now it's like they don't pick Bowser. If
it's
Mario's
like he only is Bowser Jr. now.
Yeah, if Bowser is the same age as Mario, then there's no way he can have kids in their teens.
Oh my gosh, yeah.
Ow, the Yoshis escaped during the confusion. They're a rowdy bunch, so be careful.
I mean, Mario's a thick mustache for being 25.
I know.
The show got interrupted and the audience is getting restless. Someone's got to entertain them until the next performer is ready.
Oh yeah.
Russell!
What?
No, that was cute.
Yeah, and then people can read it. There, you read it, people.
Russell!
Thanks for helping me escape that haunted.
No problem.
Russell! Russell! Russell!
Just thinking about that place gives me the creeps.
Russell! Russell!
I owe you big time, pal.
Russell! Russell!
I came here to bust my friends out of this cage.
Russell?
Though I'm not sure why they wanted to get out so badly.
Russell.
Maybe I'll leave him in.
Russell!
Sorry.
Russell!
I'll never get tired of this gilded cage. I can live in here forever.
What else did he say?
Russell!
I don't know. Oh, let's open this up.
Ba-dum. Yeah.
Ba-dum.
Pring.
Pring. Pring. Ha! Yeah, totally.
Russell!
Looking closely, that cage is as nice as I thought it was. I've decided I want to be cage-free Yoshi.
Russell! Russell? Russell!
I like living in cages.
Oh, yay! Get to do a terrible Bostonian accent for these guys.
Oh my gosh.
Traveling circus dudes.
There's no one in the state that watches us anymore.
There are a couple.
Have some awesome fans from
the ball that Lemmy rides is a lot more fragile than it looks. I bet it's super sharp. I have to be distracted first, though. I don't know. Lemmy vanished into thin air. Knowing him is probably part of his act. I bet he's somewhere shaking his groove thing. I swear that guy, once he hits the dance floor, he's totally incapacitated. I'm like, I don't know.
Whenever you try to do Boston, you're always a tiny bit New York in there.
No, that was Jersey.
Oh, okay. All right. It's
fine. They're all
close together.
If it sounded Bostonian, then it totally sounded
Jersey.
They're all
close together. There's people that move between the different states, so you're one of those people. East Coast, basically.
I really feel like when we moved from Massachusetts, though, that I think YouTube just kind of dropped our channel because...
Wasn't in Massachusetts.
It was doing so much better, like near Boston. I think it's just because if you live near a big city, they like promote you, something like that.
Really?
I think that's what they do. Yeah.
Wow.
I could be wrong. You got a disco ball. This relic from years past is making a comeback. No one can resist the recall of the hit the floor with dances or something.
Could always have an office somewhere.
Yeah. I could. Alrighty, well, I'm ready to head into the circus.